Julian, I welcome you to Apache Spirit Ranch. We are a guest ranch that is built in the shadow of Shefflin Monument. Ed Shefflin was the founder of Tombstone. And we are just located 2 miles out of the famous western town of Tombstone.
So the way this is set up, each of the buildings has like a name on it, like Miss Kitty's Bordello. And this is how you actually identify the rooms?
Yeah. The rooms have numbers, but they also have all names. And what we did try to do is really set it up like a western town setting. So we do have the Bordello, we do have the saloon, we do have the jail, the marshal's office. This is actually the Miss Kitty room. And let's have a look. Rooms that have 2 queen-size beds, so we would, at the maximum, be able to accommodate 4 people.
Great old armoire. Oh my. And this is all new.
This place is all new. This is not even 2 years old. And we try to have a standard of a 3-star hotel with our, you know, the service we have with our towels, and we have shampoo for the guests, and we have a hair dryer, and we also have a heater in the shower, so when you step out of the shower, you stay warm. Actually, this room has a bed in the living area and a separate bedroom.
Wow, that's a great bathroom.
And here is a separate bedroom. It also has its own TV.
Is there a refrigerator?
Yeah,
oh, it's a sink.
This one even has a kitchenette. So you have your own fridge, your own sink, and all the rooms actually have this little coffee area.
The furniture's so pretty.
We also have special accommodations for handicapped people. We have one room where you can just come with your car, park right here, and then if you're in a wheelchair, just roll inside. It's a handicapped and wheelchair accessible room. Even the bathroom, you can roll in with your wheelchair and be still comfortable. And all our suites have a own patio with a view of the Dragoon Mountain.
What is this little tray on the floor?
Well, as you can see, I already put one boot there. That is for your boots, you know, when you come from the outside. You can just put it there. Don't worry about mud. Don't worry about dirt.
Great. Okay, so this little sign.
That tells you about what the plan for the day is, you know, when breakfast starts. Normally breakfast is at 8, lunch at 12, and dinner at 6. But it also tells you when we have special events going on, like a trip to Tombstone, or we take our guests to the Dragoon Mountains, or we do ATV rides with them. Whatever is planned, we'll find on this board, and you will also find in the reception area.
Okay, that's where we're going now.
This is our reception area where we welcome guests. You can check in, you can check out, you can book your rides, you can just come and drop in for dinner, or enjoy our saloon.
Okay, let's head to the saloon.
Yeah. So this is our bar and our saloon, where we serve drinks and alcohol, and where at night, most of the time, we have something going on, either live music or karaoke, or we actually have a guy coming out from the Tombstone Reptile exhibit, and he shows us all the snakes and spiders and scorpions that are in this area, and he teaches our guests about what to watch for and how they act and what they need to do when they actually run into one of these creatures. So that is really good. This is our pool table. We, like I said, normally have live bands or other events going on, but people can also just play pool, play a round of poker or other games. We provide a bright selection of games, so if you just want to come with your family, hang out a little bit, have a drink, and play some games, you're very welcome to do that.
Oh, so you have a collection of games that the parents could come if they want to play with their kids.
Yeah. You've got. We have Monopoly and all
and Scrabble,
other kinds of,
sort of thing.
Yeah,
okay.
All other kinds of board games and card games. And then over here, we have a very neat thing that is our glass floor. It's solid, so you can stand and dance on it if you want to. But what it shows, and I hope it comes out in the video, is the foundation of the original homestead that was on this ranch. When they were building this saloon and they were digging with the excavator, they on accident found this and they thought, oh man, this is so neat and so old, because these walls actually date back to the 1800s. So we tried to keep it and tried to expose it to public. So we set it up, we put the glass floor in, and now you can see it.
That's great. So now we're going to go see the dining room?
Yes, we are.
Oh my.
So this is our dining area where we serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And we already got it ready for dinner tonight. For dinner, we normally serve a three-course meal with a salad or appetizer, a main dish, and then a very good dessert. Our chef is really, really good. Everybody loves him. All the guests are really, really happy with what he cooks. And so are we.
So if someone has special dietary needs, what do they need to do about that?
Just let us know ahead of time so our cook can prepare, and he will make sure that everything is all right. We have actually had a lot of people that were lactose intolerant. We have had vegetarians. So if you don't like if you just don't like fish or don't like a certain kind of meat, we can accommodate that as well.
That's great. And it's a buffet, so people serve themselves, or are they?
No, it's a served dinner and it's a served lunch, but it's a serve yourself breakfast.
Okay, great. Thank you.
When it's hot in summer, you can relax, you can cool off. We also have a whirlpool, and at night we lit all these torches. It's really romantic. You can have a margarita, you can chill out, and you can relax from your rides.
And the view is spectacular.
They really look good when the sun gets down and it shines in this reddish color. It's very, very beautiful. Well, now I would like you to introduce you to our head wrangler, Brad, who takes care of all our horses, who takes people out on rides, and who is an amazing teacher and giving very, very good riding lessons. So, Brad, tell us about the horses.
Well, right now we have about 26 head of horses here, all different skill levels. We have horses for beginners, we have horses for more advanced people. One of the main things you want to think about when you come, always bring the boots. We do carry boots a few extra times. That's one thing that is required, is to bring boots to ride in. We have plenty of saddles, different size saddles. We have a big selection of trails. We have a lot of guests here for weeks at a time. We can take them and not go on the same trail twice. So there's a lot to see. We have petroglyphs. We have a cave that a man lived in for 13 years we ride by. The mountains. It's just a beautiful place to come and ride.
Yeah, and we have all the washes where we can see where the cowboys and the Indians get out.
We offer walking rides, we have lope rides, we have...
What's a lope ride?
A galloping ride. We go do mine tours. We have some old silver mines we go to and you can check out. We ride the washes. It's a good place to gallop the horses.
And who's this horse here we have?
This is LW. He's getting a little bit of grain. We're trying to put a little weight on him. Get him fattened up a little bit. He's a new horse. Had the vet out, had his teeth all checked, and he's on the pickup again. We just give him a little extra, trying to help him out.
And who we have here poking her face through the fence?
That's Bullet.
All right, take Bullets
he
fast.
He wants the grain too. But as you can see, he don't need any. A lot of the guests like to come down and make cowboy coffee for them. Once or twice a week, we'll cook a cowboy breakfast down here for them. Eggs and potatoes and tortillas. And that's one of the ways we like to start the mornings around here.
How do you make the cowboy coffee? Can you explain that to us?
Cowboy coffee is we hang our pot over the fire, water, dump the coffee right in on top of the water, bring it to a boil, pull it off the heat, let the ground settle, and you got cowboy cough. This is my partner, Eunice. She's a real cowgirl. She's been in a ranch family her whole life. They have their own ranch, and she's invaluable to me down here. We really enjoy having her here with us. We have a big array of saddles for people. We have old saddles. We have new saddles. All different size saddles for people. And we also have our roping dummy. We do a lot of practice. Eunice, she's really good at that. She'll throw the rope and teach the guests how to throw the rope. And
Eunice, could you show us? Could you show us a little bit of that? Could you show us how you...
This. You're videoing me on this.
It's all right. It's all right. It's okay if you don't mind. That'd be great. So, Eunice, are you... You were born and raised here?
Well, about an hour that away. It's in Canelo, Arizona.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. My family owns a ranch out there. It's been in our family for over 100 years now.
Wow. Where'd you learn how to handle the rope?
Well, I think my brothers taught me, first of all. A little bit of space right here, that's called your spoke. A little bit of space in between your loop and your coils. This is your coils right here. You just keep your hand out in front of you.
Oh, great. You get that really close to the top of your head, your hat there.
Yeah.
You ever knock your hat off?
A couple times, yeah. I've roped myself.
That's great. Thanks for showing us that.
Okay, this is our tack room down here. We kind of have decorated up a little bit with some old saddles and some old pots and pans. And this is kind of where the cowboys hang out. And occasionally we'll have cowboy coffee here in the mornings also. The other area was for bigger groups. This won't accommodate quite as many people, but this is where we hang out. Keep all of our gear inside the tack room here. Bridles and little grain for the horses, things like that.
Okay, and I see that you're wearing spurs.
Yes.
And so can you tell me a little bit about the purpose of spurs today? Because I always thought, you know, it was just to make a horse go fast.
No, they're not. They're a training aid for teaching your horse. Riding a horse, a lot of people want to do everything with their hands and the bridle. In reality, it's done with your legs, your seat, how you sit on the horse. You control your horse's speed by how you sit on your horse. If you're set down hard on your horse, it'll slow him up. So it's just a training aid. It's not something to punish your horse with. It just helps you teach that horse to move off of your leg. When you're teaching a horse things like that, a horse's natural instinct will move into pressure. If you apply pressure with your leg, a young horse will move into that pressure. You teach them the exact opposite. You want them to move away from that pressure so you can guide that horse with your leg.
So the spurs don't actually hurt the horse?
No. It ain't made to punish it. It's made
so
to
this
teach
is them. One main part of our Indian village. We have two wiki-ups that Joe, our Apache Chiricahua Indian, built the way his forefathers built this already hundreds of years ago. It's a deal where they were sitting together, they were talking about their culture, and that's what we are doing here with Joe. We have campfires at night, and he talks about his Indian culture, about his history, and shares some stories with our guests.
Okay, and
these are the wiki ups, yeah. And this is a shadow harbor, which the Apaches built to get out of the sun and to be a little bit, you know, protected from the seasons. What the Apaches did, though, is everything they built was always the way that when they turned it off and tore it apart, that nobody would see that they even were there. They wanted to be a part of nature and not intrude in nature. So everything we see is built with nature and can be destroyed, and you will never see that they even were here.
No impact.
No impact on nature whatsoever. We are in our event barn. We are not using this for events. We are normally storing our hay in here, But we also do clean it up and rent it out for your private party, like your wedding, or your birthday party, or your family reunion. You name it, and we take care of it.
So this could be a whole wedding party event where people could come and stay at the hotel.
Exactly.
And the whole, everything is done here.
Exactly.
What a great
idea. We take care of the food, we take care of the drinks, we take care of, we have servers that can serve you the food, or we just make a buffet where you can, you know, serve yourself.
And barbecues outside?
Barbecues. We have barbecues very often, actually, for normal guests and our normal vacation stays. Barbecue up at the kitchen. There's a little patio where we do barbecues or chili cookouts where the guests can compete against each other and do their pot of chili, and then we choose a winner.
And how many, if you were to bring your wedding party here, how many guests could you actually accommodate right here at the ranch?
Accommodate, we could, in all our rooms, up to 39 people.
39 people. But for the events, you can accommodate, if you were to have an event in the barn, how many people could we accommodate here?
Well, for next weekend, we have a birthday party for an 80-year-old lady, and we have 85 people in the barn.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Perfect.